black male, white t-shirt, red and black shorts.
Two Atlanta police officers respond to a call in a South Atlanta neighborhood. When they arrive, it's a 13-year-old boy accusing a 10-year-old of pointing a weapon at him following an argument during a neighborhood football game. One says it was a real pistol. The younger child claimed it was a BB gun. 11 Alive is not identifying the children.
Who had the gun?
It was a cat gun.
It was a cat gun? Where's the cat gun at?
Throw it down there.
What'd you throw it down there?
The elementary student never runs away, is not combative, or denies having a weapon. Instead, he walked the officers over two doors down to a wooded area barefoot, where he says he tossed it.
Oh, you threw it in here?
Instead of searching for a weapon, the officers walk away.
That's how grandma's a BB gun, I guess. I'm not going in the woods.
I'm not either.
20 minutes later, an officer asks the 10-year-old to put on his shoes.
Is it right here?
And then handcuffs him behind his back.
Could you go ahead and put your hands behind your back? We're going to put this jacket on. I'm not going to
try. Why you got to put that behind your back?
Listen, ma'am. It's our procedures and everything.
Okay, why are you telling me now? Why you got to do it in front of you?
We can't. The only people who can do it is if they're pregnant.
Can you put it in front of me?
I can't.
It's going to hurt my back.
Johnny Harris is the child's mother.
So please don't put the handcuff. I asked her, I practically beg.
Her son is then walked out the front door and into the back of a patrol car, neighbors watching. This was the child's first interaction with law enforcement.
Why are we arresting him?
Meg Strickler is a criminal defense attorney not affiliated with the case.
Why did this escalate to, we're talking to one party, we talked to the other party, there was an issue, but without the gun, all it is a tiff. So you've marred his record forever. Without even looking for it. So if you're telling me it was a serious situation to make these charges, but yet you don't look for the gun, absolute wide hole of disconnect. I don't understand that.
The October 2019 arrest mirrors similar incidents captured on police body cameras and cell phones over the past few years throughout the country, including this 8-year-old boy in Key West a few months ago.
All right, put your hands behind your back.
And this little girl arrested in Orlando last year. She was 6 years old. In each case, the officers say they were following department procedures.
Well, I hate to tell you this, but maybe with kids you need to re-look that procedure.
Stephen Teske is the chief juvenile court judge in Clayton County, Georgia. He's a nationally known advocate for detention reform, testifying before Congress four times.
Research shows detention results in harsher treatment of a youth throughout their involvement with the system.
In 2003, Clayton County reformed its juvenile court system, which includes not handcuffing children unless it's an emergency. Since then, juvenile crime has dropped 80% in the county.
And if we already know the research that kids are twice as likely to drop out of school, to become more criminogenic when we handcuff them and detain them, then maybe we need to start asking ourselves, hey, systemically, should we take another look at these procedures and put a little bit more, you know, criteria around when handcuffs should go on a kid who's not acting violently at the moment?
According to Atlanta City records, APD officers have arrested at least 267 children who are 12 years old or younger over the past 5 years, most for minor offenses like property crime. The department says it doesn't know how many of them were handcuffed. Rodney Bryant is Atlanta's interim police chief.
Do you think this is a policy that Atlanta Police Department should have on the books?
I think that is one that we can take a look at and reevaluate. I want it to be clear that it's never our intention to traumatize a child. We know that a child seeing their parent being arrested can be traumatic. I think that you have to take everything in its totality. I know 10-year-olds that are stronger and taller than you and I. And that could be very concerning, especially when they become violent.
When the 10-year-old boy arrived at the Atlanta precinct, the officer handcuffed him to a bench for nearly 3 hours.
Kids do commit crimes, but when you take a child at a tender age and you put a handcuff on them, it rocks their world. It changes everything for them, regardless how much one may think that that's a consequence that he should have thought of. Kids don't think of it that way.